Traditionally, a fish hatchery is where fish eggs are artificially fertilized, hatched, and raised. Then, once they become juveniles, they're released into the wild. At the Yakama Nation's Salmon Hatchery in Prosser, Washington, they're doing something else. Here, they're rejuvenating kelts, which are wild adult steelhead that have recently spawned.
The steelhead have a unique life cycle where they don't have to die after they spawn, like a salmon does. So with the kelts, they'll drift back out and act like a giant smolt, trying to go back out to the ocean. You know, you can imagine the journey they had coming back from the ocean, fighting the predators, the currents, and then spawning in the wild. When they're drifting back out to the ocean, there's no energy left in them. So we intercept them after they spawn, hold them in our facility, recondition them, hope they get their eggs to regenerate, and then release them back into the system. We saw these fish leaving the river system and knowing they don't seem to be repeat spawning, so how can we help them out?
53.
And rather than put another hatchery setting in like you do for salmon, we're using their unique life cycle. Yeah, so we intercept them, we give them a safe environment, we treat them for any type of diseases, give them some antibiotics and the feed, and then again, let them go back out and do their thing.
Got it, straight to these.
Okay.
62. 5.4%. 3.4.
We'll put a pit tag in all of our steelhead that we're working on today, just to track and to get some evaluation on how they're doing. Well, this is just a way to name the fish. And when the fish first comes in, we'll do meristics. We'll do some lengths and weights and scale samples, DNA samples. And with this tag, we can link it back to the original fish. So even with this offspring, we'll be able to go through and say, this fish produced this many fish here. It's a valuable tool to have for monitoring the success of our programs.
Straight release.
Steelhead are different than salmon. They're actually a sea-run rainbow trout, so they can repeat spawn like freshwater trout. This characteristic is called iteroparity. Unfortunately, there aren't many kelts left in the Columbia River Basin. The steelhead populations that originate above Bonneville Dam are listed under the Endangered Species Act. The historical numbers of downstream migrating kelts are not well documented, but current rates show high mortality due to flows, pollution, and fish passage.
The bottom line is the rivers changed, the flows have changed, the fish passages were designed for the smaller fish, not a big 2-foot smolt.
Only 1.5% of the spawning population is made up of these repeat spawners. We're trying to come up with any kind of novel approach to restoration that would rebuild populations. If we could boost that to 20% or 30%, then we've made a sizable increase to the population.
The Columbia River Intertribal Fish Commission, in collaboration with the Yakama Klickitat Fisheries Project, has been reconditioning kelts from the Yakama River since 1999, and so far, the results are encouraging.
We've actually radiotagged some of the fish and videotaped them spawning in the wild, and that's exciting. And with the pit tags, we've had them come back into our system for a third time. They've gone up and spawned a second time, and they've come back through, so we're seeing evidence that it's happening. Now we're going to try and see how viable the eggs are. And we're doing that with artificial spawning channels and with more radio tags.
After 6 to 8 months of nurturing, feeding, and growing, these refreshed kelts are ready to be released back into the wild.
When we release them, they look like they're fresh fish out of the ocean. So they're big and they're bright and they're full of eggs. They'll go back into the tributaries in another couple months and start spawning. After that, they'll drift back out like smolts, and we'll see them March through June back in our system again, hopefully ready to go through another cycle.
Had we not intervened, those fish would have died. They would have perished. Instead, a good number of them are going to go back upstream and spawn again.
With this, we allow the fish to go back out and spawn in their own habitat, pick their own mates, pick their own areas, and spawn without interfering with their genetic makeup. I think this tool will be around for a while to help with the steelhead population.